Let's see now Faraday's experiment. Faraday performed an experiment related to electromagnetic induction. What was that experiment? In his experiment, he used one coil, a bar magnet, and a sensitive galvanometer. What he did? He connected a bar, connected a coil with sensitive galvanometer. No EMF source in this coil, so no probability of flowing current. He took bar magnet. What he observed in his experiment? Listen carefully. When north pole of bar magnet is moved rapidly towards the coil, galvanometer shows deflection. When north pole of the magnet moved away from the coil, galvanometer shows deflection again, but in opposite direction. Similarly, when south pole is moved towards the coil, galvanometer shows deflection, right? And when south pole is moved away from the coil, galvanometer shows deflection again. I repeat quickly. When we move north pole rapidly towards the coil, there is a deflection in galvanometer. When this is north pole is moved away from the coil, there is a deflection in galvanometer. South pole is moved rapidly towards the coil, there is a deflection. South pole is moved away from the coil, still there is a deflection. But either of the pole, north or south, if it is rapidly moved towards the coil and suddenly stopped, the deflection in galvanometer becomes zero. It was very surprising. Earlier it was thought that electromagnetic induction is basically a phenomenon in which electric current is produced by the conversion of magnetic field. Fundamental things are still same. Why there is a current in the circuit? Because we are rapidly moving magnet, relatively moving magnet towards the coil. So the magnetic flux link with the coil changes. You can tabulate into a small table like this. Here you can say what? Pole of magnet. Which pole moving? Coil. Direction. Or I can put second column direction. Third is coil and then deflection, and one more you can introduce here for serial numbers. Now you see, symbolically you can understand. Serial number 1, north pole is moved towards the coil. Deflection in galvanometer, say it comes out to be towards right. So when north pole is moved away from the coil, the deflection will be left towards the coil in galvanometer. When south pole is moved towards the coil, deflection will be in the left in galvanometer. When south pole is moved away from the coil, deflection in galvanometer towards right. And when it is suddenly stopped, then no deflection. See, deflection in current shows that deflection in galvanometer shows there is a current in the circuit. And of course, this current is induced. This current is induced because there is no EMF source is connected in the circuit. So no probability of flowing current. So this phenomenon is actually termed as electromagnetic induction. What is termed as? Electromagnetic induction, EMI. So what is electromagnetic induction? You can now summarize the thing. What is electromagnetic induction? It is a phenomenon of inducing an EMF or current in the coil due to relative motion between coil and magnet. It is termed as It is the phenomenon of inducing an EMF or current in the coil due to relative motion between coil and magnet. The moment relative motion breaks down, the deflection moves towards zero. Now the EMF induces first, so this is termed as induced EMF. And once EMF or potential difference is there across the ends of the wire, then obviously current flows. This is termed as induced current. Now another question comes in the mind, can we introduce or induce a current in the circuit without using bar magnet? It is also possible. Electromagnetic induction phenomenon is not necessarily need a bar magnet and one bar magnet and one coil. Rather, you can have two coils. Keep these coils face to face. Rather, I can make it like this. Coil 1, coil 2. You can easily call one coil, give any name. I have already given 1 and 2. Now, connect this coil 1 with alternating EMF source. What is alternating EMF source? This source provides you time varying current and time varying EMF. So the current which is flowing through the coil is continuously changing. And every time current carrying, this we know from the previous magnetic effect of current, that a current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Now since time varying current is flowing in this coil, so the magnetic field generated and produced by the coil will also be time varying, or it will be time dependent. So once you keep another coil which is not connected to any EMF source near to the coil 1, the magnetic field produced by the coil which is a time varying gets linked with the second coil. When it gets linked with the second coil, this coil induces an EMF and current. So this is another way of producing. Now let's see the Faraday's laws. If we talk about Faraday's laws, these are nothing but just conclusion of experiment, his experiment. So he gave two laws. First law, what is that first law? Whenever there is, or whenever there is change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, an EMF is induced in the coil. And this induced EMF lasts as long as there is change in magnetic flux. So what is the first law? Whenever magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, it induces an EMF or current in the circuit, right? And this induced EMF lasts as long as there is change in magnetic flux linked with the circuit. Second law is basically measuring the magnitude of induced EMF. It says the induced EMF E is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux. Right? So induced EMF E is equal to minus E is equal to K delta phi B over delta T. In differentiation or differential form, you can write E is equal to K D phi B over DT. And but if n be the total number of turns, in the coil, then induced EMF you can write it as K n number of turns d phi b over dt. The value of K so obtained is minus 1. So you can generalize this statement as minus n d phi b over dt.